Hello guys, it's Pug Gaming here and welcome to a special video. And yes, in special I mean we have finally hit the 1k barrier in terms of subs on YouTube. So guys, thank you very much. This is an amazing early Christmas present for myself. I didn't think we'll get to it this quickly, to be honest. I thought it would be some point in the new year, but to get this before Christmas has been absolutely phenomenal, and I thank you all for your support. It's been amazing, an amazing journey. And to celebrate this, I just thought we'll basically do a run through on everything I've done so far in the British Challenge. So it's just gonna be a bit of commentary over the episodes, maybe a few ideas on what I would have done differently, etc. But hopefully it will show you how far I have personally improved my gameplay in this game itself, in this series, and I look forward to sort of hearing your feedback after. So let's start with episode number one. Now it really does show me, looking back, how far I've come. The intro, for example, I was so pleased with this when I first made it. I thought it was absolutely amazing, and the theme tune I loved, and everything was pretty much perfect, I thought, and you can see how far that has come since those early days. So episode one, this was pretty much what started the channel off. I had seen a lot of stuff on YouTube already, a lot of people doing the typical sort of city builds, and I wanted to do something a little bit different myself. I wanted to create this sort of British theme that I'm used to seeing every time I sort of walk around my local area, and that includes a lot of farm area and sort of more smaller villages and sort of hamlet areas. So what I decided was I'd start with this little farm area, to be honest. And the only thing I'd do differently on this, looking at it now, is I wouldn't have made it so boxy. I think it was difficult to get away from the box theme when I was first designing it. I didn't quite know how to sort of start, I guess. So I'd do that a lot more rounder, and you'll see a bit further down the line I do tend to change the way I do the farms further forward. So then episode two, we moved on to creating a small British town, and it was actually based upon a town very local to me, obviously not the whole thing but a segment of it. And what I really wanted to get across here is the fact that we don't see that many boxed areas in the UK. It's a lot of bendy roads and things going all over the place, so I wanted to generate that, and that's why the layout here was very, very different. And I wanted to really compact the area with some foliage and trees, which you'll obviously know later on down the line becomes an obsession more than anything with myself. But I was really pleased with how this came across in the end. The tree areas, which worked extremely well, it just felt like an area that I live in, which is pretty much what I was going for. And I think despite how well this looked and ended up in the end, I did find it extremely difficult to get into the game. There was many times when I started building this where I found it hard to get the inspiration going, which did make building extremely hard. And that's why I wasn't too sure at first if I was going to create a YouTube channel with the City Skylines game on it. It does seem that sometimes you need to have your inspirations flying, and for me personally, it just felt like once I had the road layout sorted, or in fact the first part to bring the actually start of the city out, which if you can see from my start of the city was a roundabout with a road going back against it. Once I had that down, it was easy. I just needed that foundation just to get things going in my eyes, and that's pretty much how I personally got this build going. And you need a starting point, in my opinion, to really excel. And this episode here, episode three, was all about the detailing. And this is where the game really, really came alive to me. We also introduced this new introduction video, which I was extremely pleased with. Obviously, fits the theme perfectly with the buildings and zooming in on the main video logo. So episode four was the introduction of a golf course, and I'll be honest, I was waiting quite some time to really get this going. I'd seen so many videos and people on Reddit posting their own variations of golf courses, and it was one that I was really excited to start work on. And I designed it pretty much based on a golf course very local to me, with a bit of difference in terms of the lakes, etc. But the idea of it going across the main road and a little tunnel underneath was an idea that I stole from a real-life golf course nearby. So this came across well in my eyes and I was extremely pleased. I wouldn't have done anything different, to be honest. Now, episode 5, we then moved on to the introduction of the posh town. And what gave me this idea was, next to the golf course we've got this huge lake. And it just gave me the inspiration of this area being a bit more of a wealthier area. Not a big built-up area, but one that would just sort of house some sort of posh areas. Nothing over the top, really. I just wanted to enclose a small sort of village, I guess, with a possible housing estate beyond that as well. And I wanted to create a few focal points as well. So you'll see shortly I added this pier in here. Which in the end worked out extremely good in my opinion. And this is the area here where I created, this was the sort of housing new estate that I designed, and this is when I started to experiment a bit more with some of the props and tree and foliage bits, and also the terrain, well not terrain, this is when it was the painting tools. This is well before the decor lot came out. This is a good few months beforehand, but it was just getting used to it, and that's what I loved about this series. You can see how I'm progressing personally in the videos, but you can also see how much different props and assets and mods really sort of push this game and the levels higher and higher to more realism. And in terms of changes, the only thing I would have changed, and I actually did in the next episode, was that pond, which was far too blue for my liking in this area. So this episode we moved on to a bit of expansion, a little bit more detail work, and it was just sort of topping up what we already done. And we created the water pool itself here, put a cricket course in as well, and yeah, pretty much got things going that way. And that led us on to this, which was the introduction of the first sort of major town. So this again is based upon a town in Hertfordshire. The main core, in fact. I mean, I actually used Google Maps to sort of draw out some of the main roads, which I do find quite helpful. I don't like the idea of copying things like for like exactly all the time. I know I've been doing the Chelsea challenge, but it's sometimes nice to do things from scratch, from yourself. So I put down the basis here, and you can actually see from this video here, this was the basis of the main town. So that is pretty much like for like, but everything else beyond that was my own creation. Like this little area here was my own creation. So that's a bit of advice I'll give you guys if you're struggling to really get going, especially if you're trying to create something different like a British town. But just have a look on Google Maps. Whether you look at the view where you can see everything in all the detail, or just the roads, whichever you prefer, just try it out. And I guarantee you it will certainly help and change the way you play. So certainly keep that in mind, and let me know how that goes for you. But one thing I do like about this build was these British UK based houses. They do look so realistic, and if I was to take a picture outside my window now, you would see these are pretty much identical to the houses and homes and bits and bobs that are around me. The detail that's gone into them has been absolutely incredible, and all we can do really is pretty much just thank everyone involved in creating all these mods and assets. They do it for free, and it's just an incredible job to have and offer to us to play with. So this next episode was the recycling industrial area, and this was pretty much required because, well, as you can see, all of my zoning and requirements were so low. The building, well, all of the junk and rubbish was building up immensely, and I need to do something about it. So I used this as an excuse to create a small, I guess it's fairly large for what this area is, but an area where we can have like a dump and a recycling zone. So again, this was where I was able to create something a little bit basic but really excel in terms of my detailing abilities and really make this area come alive, which it really does in my eyes. It allowed me to find a lot more props on the workshop. And to be honest, that's really what triggers these ideas for me as well. Whether it's something I need in terms of the gameplay telling me I need it, or if it's just a prop I found on a website, or anything on there, I find that that really does inspire me to create my next build. So guys, always keep up to date on what's on the workshop, that really does help. So we then carried on work on the main town itself, and this was a little area that I copied again from a local town to me, and we wanted to create a market area here. So using all the assets and props on the workshop and making use again of the floor tiles, which again, as I say, these were all we really had at this point of me designing this. Now if I was doing this again, I'd use all of the decors and really take advantage of the Move It mod and others really. This is very vanilla in terms of how I play the game today, but it was a very nice market area in the end, and it did work well for me. So as you can see here, the detail I put in here was probably one of the highest levels of detail I've done, and the video got a lot of feedback and a lot of likes, so I was extremely pleased by how that was sort of fared with you guys out there. But yeah, this worked out really nice, and it really started to bring alive this town area. And next we move on to one of my favourite actually outro videos, and this is the first person view round the town centre. And it was an idea that a lot of you had sort of suggested to me, using the first person sort of walking view, and I must say it was really fun, and it did really sort of really bring what I built to life, and it just made things a lot more realistic. Like just looking around here, adding in these lights around the cinema and seeing the houses over the top of the trees, it just makes things look so much more realistic, and it also shows off how detailed some of these props and assets actually are. Like, it's amazing how much detail people put into some of these props and assets. It's absolutely incredible. But unfortunately, after this episode, my first person view kind of died off, and I tried a few others and none of them really worked to what I expected them to work in terms of how well this one did work. It's something I'll look into again, maybe as a very final video when we finish the British challenge. But in terms of what this video showed, it certainly did make things come alive, and I really did enjoy just looking around and seeing all the details of different buildings. I think you sometimes forget how different some of the buildings are when you're looking at them. But this is what things look like at the end of the episode. We got the main core of the town down, and it was now time to move on to what I called as the city center. And this is the one which I based it upon Milton Keynes. So this, despite me saying I don't work in grids, this was a very grid light design in mind. But rather than having the traffic lights in terms of how they do in the States, my idea was to copy the MK trend of having little roundabouts at each section of road pretty much, and just build a big mass sort of grid with roundabouts. So the first part of this video, or the first part of this zone, was to create the transport area. So we was going for a big train station with hotels around it. That was the plan, and again, I did actually copy Milton Keynes like for like as best I could in this top tier zone. The rest I sort of carried on sort of as I wanted to myself. So it was interesting to really sort of excel and copy as best I could the MK train station. And it didn't work out too bad. Again, as I say, this is where my love for foliage and trees really came into account. And it was this point where I found the combination of the two trees, which you pretty much will see throughout the rest of this series, and it just works incredibly well for what I'm trying to show off, really. Very British tree combinations, in my opinion. So in the next episode, we moved on to a industrial zone, and my idea here was to have an industrial area right by the side of the river, where we could then add a little harbour, etc. And this is where all the factories would be, so they're kind of out the way. I know we could have had something a bit more luxurious by the side of the river, but I wanted to give that sort of harbour type industrial feel for this zone. And it wasn't as big as I planned to in the first place, I must admit, It was a lot smaller in terms of the harbour area, but I was able to add in some good lorry distribution areas, some sort of smaller offices and warehouses. So it really did come alive in terms of this being a city centre. And yeah, that's pretty much what's happened in this episode. It's a very, very build conscious episode, this one. So as we can see here, that was the top half of the train station area up there, and this was the build that we worked on. And I did separate it here with some bush and trees and a little pathway in between, and that's what you see quite often, especially in Milton Keynes. They've got the sort of separation of one area to another, and I really like that. I know a city centre often breaks into the housing areas, but I wanted to sort of create this city centre with a little bit more organised, I guess. So this sort of harbour industrial area was sort of blocked off with some thick tree foliage, and also the pathways which lead people from the station right up into what will become the main shopping centre. But this is when Avanya started to release these absolutely amazing props, warehouses, etc. So I took full advantage of adding as many as I could here. This area here, I probably could have spent a little bit more time on in the end. I think my project ideas sort of overhauled what I was concentrating on during this episode, and I did sort of minimize how much effort I put into the additional warehouses and that. But that's what happens sometimes in City Skylines. You do get carried away and you get very excited to start the next episode as quickly as you possibly could. So what happened next? We moved on to creating the commercial zone, and we used all the commercial UK buildings here, and the plan here was to use as many as we could, but just sort of place them to look a bit more realistic, so they're not all in the line. There's a bit of variation around that. And I actually did as well, a bit further down in this video, create the first construction site that I well, obviously I do the proper construction site after, but it really gave me a good idea to sort of push that into the next episode after. But I really did enjoy doing the construction site, and it was only a small one just to sort of show that this area is being built up and we're going to have other stuff here in the future. So to sort of show again that this area is growing, and it's you know, not just an old destruction area, it's all going to be built up, and the area itself is obviously a big city centre, so you do see a lot of buildings being rectified and even made from scratch. So the last video in this first of two parts of the special 1K British Challenge overview was the retail park, and I wanted to create something a little bit special here. I wanted to do something very, very different to what anyone else has done and what I've done before. So I wanted to create a sort of zone itself which is very commercial based, with the cinema to one side and some food areas beyond that as well, and really sort of create my own gardens. For example here, the McDonald's was the one which I was extremely pleased with in the end. Again, all down to experiments, I actually found a few ways of making some grass, as you can see there, just by adding in a couple of different sort of props and that. It didn't work out the best. There was times where you could see the gaps of adding extra bits in together, but it was the start of something, and I think these are the sort of things that gave people ideas in the workshop to really make new props and assets for things that people have pretty much what I call bodged together, really. But as I say, if people don't trial things out, people don't do things, then we never actually get anything going. So guys, that was it for this first part of the special 1K video. I'm also open to new ideas for you guys. If there's anything else you want to see, any videos, any new games you'd like to see, let me know. I'm always looking to expand the channel itself, and I have got a few videos. I've got a few new games that I've already purchased ready for 2017. So I'll be releasing a video at some point with that update. But until then, I'll catch you in the meantime. Thanks for watching. All the best.